I showed you how to do deep learning with a matrix determinant, and what I discovered with this is that I could not generalize the determinant. I could get it to learn a system of equations for a determinant and then predict it, predict that determinant for that matrix, but I could not come up with a generalized approach for it to learn the determinant underlying algorithm. And so, you know, you cannot use deep learning from a deterministic point of view to do determinant calculations in general, but you can in specific, and I'll just show how I did it. So you can use the libraries I have. It's NumPy, model, dense, input. And I'll show you how I break up the matrix into arrays, and then arrays into tensors that input into keras. That's kind of important. We'll do a concatenate merge on the arrays to create a matrix so we can output it, so we can see what it looks like. Train test split. And then we'll bring in our keras deep learning model, and then we'll set our callback for early stopping. Okay, so here's our array. So you have a matrix 4, 3, 2, minus 2, 2, 3, 3, minus 5, and 2. And then we have another matrix 25, 10, minus 10, 4, and minus 4. And then we will create a inverse of the A matrix. So we have the array, and we'll have a matrix of that, and we can print out the matrix. So there's our matrix, and then we can take the dot product of it, and it will then produce X. So here was the original set of equations where we're looking for the B is over here. So we got a set of equations, and here's our solutions, 25, minus 10, and minus 4. So the solution that it found is 5, 3, and minus 2. So let's see, if you take 15 minus 15 minus 4, that's 4. So that's a solution then to that set of equations. So what we're finding then is a solution for a set of equations. That gives you the determinant. That's what the determinant does. So it's valuable in the sense that if you have multivariate analysis like linear programming, you have a set of equations that you can put together, maybe looking for an optimization. These could represent different amounts or quantities, and you're looking for a certain goal. You can then figure out what the variables are in between using the determinant. So the determinants are practical and useful in business. Okay, so then we set up our tensors. We're going to tell it that it's one-dimensional. Everything is one-dimensional. And we'll set up 4 tensors, one for each layer of the matrix, and then our output. So this will be column 1, column 2, column 3, and then our coefficient. Not a coefficient, but our B matrix before. So then we can concatenate the tensors together, tensor 1, 2, 3, 4. And then I'm going to set up a hidden layer of 50 and another hidden layer of 50. And then we'll use an RLU activation. And then so our model then will have 1, 2, 3, 4 inputs, tensors, and then one output tensor. So what we do is we take the merged will go into the hidden, and the hidden will go, one will go into hidden two, and hidden two will go into the output. So then we can then show the model. So we have tensor 1, 2, 3, and 4 being fed into concatenation, which is going into the hidden layer, and then the second hidden layer, and then we have an output layer. Okay, so now in order to take the data, we take our A data, which is was defined here. This is our array for the A data. That's 4, 3, 2, minus 2, 2, 3, 3, minus 5, and 2. So that's our matrix. Okay. And what we'll do is we will flatten it out, and then we'll slice it up. So 0 to 3 will be A, 3 to 6 will be 2, 6 to 9. So that gives us A, and you can see A is running now vertically. B, A2 is running vertically. A3 here, A4, and this gives us our original matrix. And then X is our coefficient. So, and the coefficient or the B product. Let's see, X. Okay, so that's so what that's saying is that's our target. So we know that our target's 5, 3, and minus 2. That's what we want to achieve. So we put in our 1, 2, 3. Actually, this needs to be one more. That would be B. Oh, okay, but we do already have B there. So there's our B, which should be 25 minus 10 minus 4. And then our target then for the determinant is 5, 3, and minus 2. Okay, so that's correct. So then we 1, 2, 3, and B. Yeah, correct. So what we have then for the input would be A1, A2, A3, and B. Okay, and then we'll set early stop. What early stop does is if there's no loss reduction in the network, then it does an early stop. So three items where there's no improvement on the model, then it'll stop. Verbose, we don't look at the output, and then we'll run 1,000 epochs. So we can just epochs is 1,000 training cycles. So it converged pretty quick. And now we can feed our inputs A1 or array 1, 2, 3, and B and look at the predicted results. And you can see that let's see, that one is interesting because let's run it again. Sure that things are running here. So you can see that it gets the fairly close if we did the rounding, 5, 3, and minus 2. So that's our determinant. So it did accurately calculate our determinant and run the predictions here. And then we can see if we print out X, which is our originally determinant, compare it to the predicted results, we get 5, 2, 2 and minus 3. So we did find the determinant. And then we could take A dot the predicted results and get B. So there we get the results there, 26 minus 11 and minus 2. Let's go back up here. Okay, so taking A dot the determinant and we get the B2 and A, so then we compare the two and we take A dot X, which would be the original determinant that we calculated. Now we do the comparison between the two. And you see that it's 25 minus 10 and 4. And using the predicted determinant, we had 26 minus 11 and 2. So it's fairly close. It's not exact, but it does show you that it did find signal. And then what I did is I thought, well, okay, since I found signal there, I wonder if I can put it in, take another set of equations and then feed that into the network and if it'll give me the same results. And again, what I found here is it did calculate a determinant, but the results were different. So you can get it to learn a particular determinant, and then you can once it calculates that determinant using the neural net, it could be used to calculate a dot product. And again, what was the usefulness of the dot product? The dot product produced the value. So here we get 122, and that value can be used in your business solution. So I'm not really certain that the deep learning and the matrix multiplication is useful, but it does show you that you can train a deep learning network to solve a specific linear set of equations.